My name is Anas Aremeyaw Anas. I am an investigative reporter. I am sorry I cannot show you my face, because if I do, then the bad guys will know I'm amongst them. As we all know, cocoa is a very important cash crop for Ghana's economy. It accounts for 40% of our total export revenue. Ghana has, however, seen a decrease in its cocoa yield in recent years. As a result, I was contacted by Ghana Cocoa Board to look into the issue of smuggling within our borders. What I found is not nice to watch, but I am sorry I have to show it, because that's the only way we can turn this country around.
I tell you something now.
Yeah.
I'm a lucky.
There are goods, but the wave block there. It is very hot. If you broke, it's no problem.
On the eve of independence, the first president of Ghana declared,
"The black man is capable of managing the whole of us."
As a nation, we've done well in some areas, but have we done well with cocoa? For example, the 1999-2000 season saw the Volta region record 11,000 tons of cocoa purchased. Within just 10 years, however, this figure has dropped to as low as 400 tons. Many factors such as aging trees, widespread diseases, and bad weather have been blamed for the decreases in Ghana's cocoa. Meanwhile, smuggling continues to stand out as the major factor. The government of Ghana has, however, taken some measures to combat smuggling over the years.
Yeah, that's fine. Oh, really? You mean the security forces are involved in this? Well, it's going to be a tough call, but trust me, we'll work on it. This is definitely in the interest of the state. Yeah. Okay. Thank you. Yeah.
After the call, I and my Tiger Eye team began to put in place strategies to ensure that we uncover the cause of Ghana's dwindling cocoa yields. Prior to our investigation, though, the government formed a special armed national task force which consisted of the military, the police, SEBS and the Ghana Immigration Service, coordinated by the national security. Their aim was simple: to produce effective strategies for a sustained battle against cocoa smuggling. And so, Operation Hunter was born.
Center! Move!
With the code name Operation Hunter, the National Task Force was expected to search, locate and destroy activities of smugglers within the following cocoa growing areas: Enchi, Dadieso, Bosunquanta, Debiso, Inkrankwanta, all in the Western region. Between December 2008 and November 2009, approximately 440,000 Ghana cedis were spent on anti-smuggling operations to enable Ghana to stand up and take her rightful place, not only as the producer of the best cocoa in the world, but also the largest. Government also supplied 11 vehicles complete with drivers, fuel and radio facilities to the tune of millions of cedis to the security forces. In addition, the government of Ghana through Cocoa Board has also made provisions for tools to help with the anti-smuggling process, a scholarship scheme for the children of cocoa farmers, subsidized fertilizer cost, the rehabilitation or construction of roads into farming areas, and mass spraying exercises to reduce diseases that affect crops. Surprisingly, the cocoa industry still continues to suffer, irrespective of the resources that the government has pumped into its protection.
Armed with this information, the road ahead seemed tough for me and my team. Despite the odds, we zoomed into action. We went into major cocoa growing areas in the western region to begin work. My name was Kwame Ngwa Efuka from Sefi Enyinabu. The questions we sought to answer were, why are we as a country still plagued with cocoa smuggling? Where is the expected increase in cocoa purchases? Why did Operation Hunter fail to search, locate and destroy the smugglers? Team A, the Scorpions, first stopped at Enchi. Seemingly new in town, we posed as cocoa smugglers and spoke to this young man for assistance. Meanwhile, the spiders of Team B were on the beat. Team C, the parrots, were seriously at work at Abriwakrom, seeking answers to the cases of smuggling. The chameleons of Team D, on the other hand, also took a different turn with their discoveries. They exposed the rot within the fertilizer distribution system initiated by government. Back to Team A, who had asked this young man for assistance. That same evening, we met this taxi driver.
I'm not sure if you're going to be able to do it. I'm going to go to the hospital.